In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to convert any image from portrait to landscape or landscape to portrait. Stay tuned and I'll show you how.
Studio Shepherd.
So let's start with a nice and easy one. We're going to turn this portrait into a landscape image. So select the crop tool and I'm going to change the sizing to be landscape. And I'm just going to readjust my image in the frame. Then I'm going to deselect delete cropped pixels so we don't lose any of our image and click this fill drop down and select generative expand. Now click this tick or click enter and it will use AI to expand our image. And you can choose the best of three variations. In this next example, we're going to change this image from landscape to portrait. So selecting the crop tool, I'm going to flip this ratio to make it portrait and adjust my image. Then click enter. And you can see in this orientation, we've lost the main focus point. So she's just staring up at an empty sky. So in layers, let's make a duplicate by using the short key Command J. Move this layer so the Eiffel Tower is where we want it. Now using the lasso tool, draw a selection around the Eiffel Tower. And then create a clipping mask from that selection. We now have everything that we want within the frame, but we need to clean up some of these edges. So with the brush tool, I'm going to remove any of the image covering my subject. We also need to fix the edges around where we masked our image. So with the lasso tool, draw a selection around the edges like so. Then under Window, make sure you have the contextual taskbar selected, and then click Generative Fill, Generate. Now select the variation that looks best. So here is the before and after. Now in my final example, we're going to look at converting another landscape to portrait. So following the same steps, we're going to select the crop tool and we're going to swap it to a portrait ratio. And then make sure you've got delete cropped pixels deselected and then click enter. Now as you can see, it's cropped out a lot of our landscape and our person feels pretty tightly cropped within the frame. So to fix this, I'm going to open layers and make sure you've got your layer selected. And then we're going to hit Command T to transform our image. I'm going to scale it down until it looks about right within our frame. Then click enter. Now if we go up and select the rectangle marquee tool, we're just going to drag a selection over this empty space at the top. Then go up to window and make sure you've got contextual taskbar selected. And we're going to hit generative fill, generate. And that's going to fill in that space at the top and give us three variations of our sky. Now what I also want to do is bring in some more of the fencing detail that have been cropped out. So with our layer selected, hit Command J to duplicate our layer. And we're just going to drag it across so some of our fence post is within the frame. Now with the lasso tool, I'm just going to draw a selection around our post and then create a clipping mask from that selection. So if I zoom in here, as you can see, they don't quite blend together. So to fix this, with the lasso tool still selected, I'm just going to draw a selection around the edges. So something like this. Then again, click Generative Fill, Generate. And that's going to help seamlessly blend our fence post into our image. And so just like that, we've changed our portrait from looking like this to this. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest design tips. I'll see you in the next video.